A witness who testified before the Presidential Commission has been forced to flee the country following death threats. At today's proceedings, the Attorney General's Department said the family of the witness has also received threats. Let's now cross over where Bandhru Jayasekara is attending by with Zulfik Farzan.
Presidential Commission investigating the bond issue has decided to conclude recording of evidence today. We got more news for you. What's happening, Zulfik?
Well, Bandhru, today the Presidential Commission of Inquiry decided to conclude the recording of evidence. Now, the Commission has had sittings for 121 times and they recorded evidence from over 63 witnesses. So, officially today they concluded recording evidence. Now, however, in relation to Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, the Presidential Commission of Inquiry has sent a questionnaire to the Prime Minister and has asked him to respond to those questions via an affidavit.
To the Prime Minister, can't they ask him to come to the Commission? Why is that?
Well, according to Justice K.T. Chittasubi, who read out a statement at the Commission, once the Prime Minister sends his response to these questions via an affidavit, and if the Commission believes that the explanations are not sufficient, they will have a separate sitting at the Presidential Commission and ask the Prime Minister to testify before the Presidential Commission of Inquiry. Now, an important statement was made by Additional Solicitor General Yasanta Kodagoda, where he called Perpetual Treasuries Limited a criminal organization. He said the evidence in relation to this has been placed before the Presidential Commission of Inquiry, and the reason he says Perpetual Treasuries Limited is a criminal organization is because it is involved in insider dealing. It has had inappropriate correspondence and communication with people in authority and in politics, and Perpetual Treasuries Limited, through the evidence led before this commission, is involved in bribing its informants who gave them market sensitive and price sensitive information.
That's a very strong statement, Sulfi.
Indeed, Bandhru. The Presidential Commission of Inquiry also praised the task of the Attorney General's Department as well as the Criminal Investigations Department officers who have been assisting with the gathering of evidence and material for this commission.
When Yasanta Kodagoda said that, how did the others react? What was the reaction?
Well, there was no definite reaction from the other side. However, Yasanta Kodagoda was firm when he made that statement.
In fact, I think the country, the honest citizen, the peace-loving citizen should be thankful to the Attorney General's Department, to the Commission and to the CID, Sulfik.
Indeed.
Because they have done a great job. But then there also was a story about a key witness being threatened.
Yes, Bandhru, this all transpired when Additional Solicitor General Yasanta Kodagoda today presented a complaint that had been filed by the brother of one of the witnesses who testified before the Commission. Now, this witness, previously testifying before the Commission, she said that the penthouse that she was living in, she sold it to the family of a former minister, basically the former finance minister. Now, the brother of this witness says, after she testified before the commission, she received numerous threats from many quarters, and this forced her to flee the country. And recently, on Saturday, the brother of this witness, whose name we will not mention due to security concerns, for his own, has said that on Saturday, a person by the name of Shanil Nethikumara had called him at night and threatened him, saying that statements made before the Presidential Commission have in fact harmed this so-called Uncle Ravi. Now, accordingly, the Uncle Ravi is referred to former Finance Minister Ravi Karunanayake, which was mentioned at the Presidential Commission. Now, the brother of this witness says Nethikumara had conveyed a threat to him over the phone, and because of the testimony that his sister had given before the Presidential Commission of Inquiry implicating this former minister, Nethikumara had threatened him, the sister, as well as their father.
Sulfik, we have a Witness Protection Act and it's supposed to be very strong. And also we, the police, they know the name of this, the person who threatened. Yes. What will the CID do about it?
Well, Bandhru, once this was exposed, Additional Solicitor General Yasanta Kodagoda retweeted and requested the Presidential Commission of Inquiry to direct the Director General of the Sri Lanka Police Witness Protection Unit to immediately set up an interim protection regime for this witness and her family. He also said that an immediate criminal investigation needs to take place on the threat made by this person called Shanil Nethikumara, because the Additional Solicitor General believes this person acted on the interest of a person who was implicated by the witness.
So what happened to this witness who was hospitalized?
Well, Bandula, you are referring to the personal assistant of Arjun Aloysius, Steve Samuel. Well, he arrived at the Presidential Commission of Inquiry today. He did not seem very well, and his lawyers say he's still recovering. Now, he was confronted with a series of text messages extracted from his mobile phone. These messages are between Steve Samuel and Arjun Aloysius. Now, in these text messages, there are reference to names like AM, RK, PM, and A. Mahendran, Arjuna M. Now, when Steve Samuel was questioned who these people are, he said he does not know. He just writes down the instructions that are given to him, and then he sends it to Arjun Aloysius through a text message. However, when he was asked who A. Mahendran is, rather than saying it refers to Arjuna Mahendran, what Steve Samuel said, it refers to Anjali Mahendran, the daughter of Arjuna Mahendran and the wife of Arjun Aloysius. So he was questioned on these names, and it came to light that Arjun Aloysius had in fact had meetings with people like RK, AM, PM, and then Ravi Karunanayake. The name was mentioned in the text message, and Ravi Krishnamurthy and Saman Indika Kumara.
Sri Lanka, this is the bond gate. It is your money which has been looted. We hope justice will be served. Keep watching News First. Thank you, Sulfik.
Thank you very much, Basu.